Sunchanman Bay, formerly an abandoned land, now has a new name, Reedport. It is also the place Kim Sung-ok's novel, Journey to Mujin, was born.
The mist of Mujin. The mist that you met in the morning in Mujin. The mist that made men wait anxiously for the sun to rise and the wind to change. That mist was the most distinctive specialty to Mujin.
Mujin, the city on the other side of the mist. The protagonist of Journey to Mujin, Yoon Hwae-jung, revisited Mujin while reminiscing about his innocent young days. The city that doesn't appear on any map. To get to Mujin, one must first rid himself of the weariness of his daily existence and the heavy burdens of reality. The road to Mujin is the road to our lost past.
Mujin은 지도에는 없지만 작가 김승옥 선생이 이 순천만을 배경으로 해서 Mujin 기행을 썼다고 하는데요. 이 김승옥 선생은 이곳에서 유년 시절을 보내기도 했던 것이기도 합니다.
Yoon Hwae-jung was set to become managing director of a large pharmaceutical company, thanks to his marriage to a wealthy and well-connected widow. He comes to Mujin to take a breather, away from his busy life in Seoul. But he fails to find that peaceful rest in the cloudy mist of Mujin, unnavigable by human strength.
미래가 뭔가 아직 불투명하고 애매모호한, 그러면서 그렇게 살 수밖에 없는 조건을 우리가 갖고 있단 말이죠. 이 애매모호하고 불투명한 이 상태가 바로 우리의 한국적인 상황이고, 이것이 어떤 면에서는 바로 안개 낀 상태와 같은 것이다. 말하자면 앞길이 잘 보이지 않은, 불투명해 보이는 그런 상황 자체가 바로 우리 오늘날 1920년대 한국의 모습이다.
On the first night back in his hometown, Yoon Hwae-jung goes for a drink with friends he hadn't seen in a long time. That is where he meets Ha In-suk, the other protagonist of the novel. They persuade her to sing a popular song called The Tears of Mokpo. But The Tears of Mokpo is no longer just a popular song, as she, a woman known to have studied vocal music at a university in Seoul, sings the song for a group of vulgar town folk. The song was supposed to be comforting, by bringing everyone down to a lower class. But Yoon Hwae-jung experiences wretchedness even more wretched than the lyrics of the common popular song while listening to her singing.
그 만나는 인간들은 대부분 출세의 지상주의적인 그러한 모습들, 어떻게 보면은 속물화 되어가는 그러한 사람들에게 자기 스스로가 고립을 피해서 시들어가는 그러한 모습, 자기도 역시 속물화 되어가는 그러한 모습을 통해 가지고 주인공 윤회중이 자기 분신과 같다라는 그런 느낌을 갖게 되는 것이죠.
The most strikingly beautiful scene of the novel, Journey to Mujin, is the long embankment stretched out towards the ocean and the beach on which the two main characters share a lonely and sorrowful love.
The two of them escape the plaza of snobs and seek out a secret chamber of their own. Tired of the tedious life in Mujin, she wants to go to Seoul. In that, Yoon Hwae-jung sees himself of the younger days, the side of him buried deep inside his heart. 만 앤 워먼 suffering from loneliness and despair make love in devastation.
김승옥 debuted in 1962 with the short story Practice of Life in the newspaper 한국일보. His most notable works, such as The Journey to Mujin or Seoul Winter 1964, are lauded by contemporary critics as accomplishments that revolutionized sensibility. Yoon Hwae-jung is well on his way back to the solitary life he led as a young man with tuberculosis. He begins to wander between his past untainted self and his present worldly self.
That's where he receives a telegraph from his wife, telling him to hurry back to Seoul. The telegram allows him to see things clearly, how his actions and thoughts are those of a snob, jaded from life in the busy city, Seoul. He writes a letter to Ha In-suk, saying, I love you, but tears it up immediately. He gives up trying to reclaim his innocent self from the younger days and decides to live only within a sphere of limited responsibility. Deeply in shame, he leaves Mujin.
점차 그 산업화의 밑바탕을 마련하게 되는데 그러므로 인해 가지고 많은 인구들이 지역의 고향을 버리고 도시로 밀려들기 시작하는 그 상황에 있어서 나이가 들어감에 따라 가지고 점차 속물화되어 가는 인간의 모습, 거기에 대한 반성과 부끄러움의 한 형태를 보여주고 있기 때문이라고 생각을 합니다.
Let's affirm just for this once. For this once only and for the last time. This Mujin, the mist, maddening loneliness, pop songs, a whore's suicide, betrayal, irresponsibility. For once and for the last time, let's affirm these things. Just for this once.